Hello, welcome to another new video. My name is John and today I'm going to talk to you about Unified Access Points. Unified Access Points is a new product that replaces campus and instant AP products so that we now offer a single product that can both be a campus AP or an instant AP. UAPs, they ship with a factory default image, special manufacturing image, which allow it to discover what it needs to not needs to become, so either an instant AP or a controller-based AP. So with UAP, we are not introducing a new operating mode, but it's only a new way for access points to auto-discover their operating mode. And here on this slide, you see the first four products that ship with this UAP image. And these four products are the 303H, the 203R and RP, the 203H, and the outdoor AP 365/367, and all future AP platforms will ship as a unified access point. You can identify them on the sticker on the box, also on the product itself, so it's easy to identify what a unified AP is. Now, how does it work? So if you take a factory default UAP, it goes through this whole list to discover what it needs to be. So first, you can always assign static assignment on the AP itself. If you do that, then it will directly go to the controller, download the controller image and become a campus AP. It can be as usual based on DHCP, that's option 43. It can be based on ADP, Aruba Discovery Protocol, or it can be DNS based, Aruba minus master. In any of these four cases, the UAP will connect to the controller, download the campus AP image, and becomes a campus AP. If none of these four are configured, then we start to discover instant. So first we're going to see if there is already an instant VC active on the layer 2 subnet where this UAP is connected to. If it finds a virtual controller, then it will connect to that virtual controller, download the right image and get configured. If it doesn't find it, then it tries to discover Airwave or it goes to Aruba Activate to see if there is a match for Airwave or for Aruba Central. And also in Activate, you can configure it to become a campus AP or a remote AP. So it goes through this whole list. If none of these things work, then in the end it starts broadcasting a provisioning SSID. On that provisioning SSID, you can connect and you can then manually via graphical user interface turn the AP so into an instant AP or a campus AP by uploading the right image to it. So that's the manual way of provisioning a UAP. So I've connected a console cable to the UAP and I'm going to interrupt the boot process for a moment to check out how this UAP is shipped from the factory. So if you type OS info, it shows you that partition 0 is empty, there's no valid image, and the special manufacturing image, which is called Instant Preserve Factory, can be found in partition 1. So this is the image that will finally becomes active once this UAP goes through the whole process that I just showed you in the previous slide. So the way it discovers if it needs to be a campus AP or an instant AP, if all of that fails, then this image will become active. And I will show you how that looks in a minute. So when the UAP finally boots that manufacturing image, this is the web page that you will be shown when you connect to the SSID with the name set me up and the last digits of the MAC address of the UAP. If you then type in any URL here in the bar, it will redirect you to setmeup.arubanetworks.com on port 4343. Log in with the default username admin and password admin. And then you get to the access point provisioning page. That's the only page that you get in this manufacturing image. That's all you can do. So you can either manually turn this into a instant AP here on the virtual controller, or a campus AP or a remote AP under mobility controller. So controller-based AP, controller-based versus controller-less. So if you want to turn it into a virtual controller, you can either manually browse for a file, upload it, and you're done, or point it to an image URL to download it. And for mobility controller, either you convert it to a campus AP or remote AP, and just give the IP address of the mobility controller where it can download the image. The only other thing that you can do here is show advanced options where you can set the static IP address for the UAP, clear some configuration and reboot the UAP, and look at the debug log. And that's it. That's all you can do here. So either turn it into a instant AP or into a campus slash remote AP. And that's all on UAP. So it's a new way of having a single product that you can turn into any type of AP that you want for your deployment. So please like, subscribe, or add some comments to this video, and see you next time on a new video. Thank you very much.